Hello and welcome back to my channel again. Now I'm gonna make a brand new video about choosing the best university for your future. Watch this video carefully and get to know how to choose it. Okay, let's get started. If you are new to my channel and you don't know what this channel for, basically I'm making videos for people who want to integrate abroad for academic purposes and professional careers. Don't forget to hit that button below, subscribe to this channel, and also give me a thumbs up for helping me to grow with you together, as well as fighting with YouTube algorithm. Let's start today's topic. In this video, I'm gonna give you brief information how to choose universities, and while choosing universities, which decision you have to make. Everything will be discovered in this video. Okay, let's start from the scratch. First, what do you want to study? Because this is the most important starting your professional career and future life. If you don't make a good decision and if you don't choose the perfect field for you, in the future you will need to change your field and it will be a waste of time. Or sometimes you will not need to study and you will not need to have a degree because you have something in your mind and you can make it for a business. This is also really up to you. But generally, if you want to study in a university, these steps you have to follow. Finding the fields which are suitable for you. This is important. Why? Because at least 3 or 4 years you will spend your time in the university having some courses while studying. It can be interesting for you, or some of them you will find completely boring, and then you can upset for choosing this field because you have to know which field is matching your personality or character. And that's why for choosing this you have to do research or do some tests for choosing best field for you. Let's say you chose the field which you want to study, and the next step you want to study in your country or study abroad. This is also interesting part of your career path. What you have to know first, the countries, which is the specialized country for your field. If you want to choose some fields, for example related to neurosciences or genetics, you cannot choose Eastern Europe countries because those countries are not specialized and the university is not in advanced level for giving you the best opportunity during 3 or 4 years to be specialized. At least get some idea what are you studying, or just getting these fields deeply to you. And that's why you have to choose the best country for related to this field. For example, Singapore, Asian countries are well-developed countries for electronics, robotics, engineering fields. And those information you will need before choosing the country for studying. Okay, let's say you passed from these two stages, and what is the next? You have to find the best universities in these countries. It's possible you chose the best countries for specialized in this field, but if choosing the university, you can make mistake. Why you shouldn't make a mistake? Avoiding these stress and avoiding these problems, check the university rankings based on this field. How to check the field rankings? Don't approach for the university ranking, because this is common. You can think that this a university is the high rank in the global university list, but the field which you want to study is not well developed in this university. Generally, their ranking is really good because of their admitted students or the number of graduates. This ranking evaluated based on this filterization, but the field ranking is not good in this university, and that's why you have to choose field rankings in these universities. If you don't know how to do research about the rankings for the universities, check these two websites and get to know which one is the best for you. Number four, You chose everything and write now which steps you have to take into mind. Checking the syllabus. While studying, you will have some courses can be interesting for you or absolutely boring. How you can study. Some courses is really relevant for you because of the administration manner they put these courses on your syllabus. You cannot avoid them, you cannot remove them because it's fixed courses, and that's why it's important for checking your syllabus before applying to universities. Number five, what is the important factor for universities? Of course, their international partnership programs. Why? Because I'm studying, let's say, in Europe, and I want to make my study years a bit interesting. To participate some Erasmus events or some Erasmus traineeship internship programs, but my university doesn't have any partnership with the different universities, and that's why unfortunately I have to stuck this 3-4 years only one university, and I will not have opportunity for going abroad, for at least exchanging the universities. It's really important for you while studying to make your study years interesting. It's not possible to always study or bury yourself in a book. You need to cope with the universities and socialize, because it's important while studying to participate some events or going abroad for exchanging your fields, to think out of box and to go out of your university discovering everything. Check international partnership programs for your university. Sixth, the last one. This is, I would say, the most important factor for considering which country to go, because after graduation you will need some time to think about your future life, whether you want to continue your education or you want to find a job in different countries or the country where you study. This country should give you the permission to stay after graduation at least 1 year. For example, in Canada, after graduation, you will apply for postgraduate work permit, and with that permit, you can apply later for the PR program. It will be easier, within 2 years, you can get it. Or in the Europe, staying in these certain countries after 5 or 7 years, depending which country you are staying, you can apply for permanent resident program, which will be, I would say, opening doors for your future. And if you want to stay there and make your life in that country, this will be really useful program for you applying PR. And after 5 or 10 years having PR card, you can apply for citizenship program also. Then you can be completely citizen of that countries. If you really like this video and you got some important information, hit the button below, subscribe this channel, and also give me a thumbs up for helping me to grow with you together and fighting with YouTube algorithm, which is really important for me. That's all from me. See you in next video. Good luck in your future life. Bye bye.